Welcome to the Getting Started with Minitab webcast. The main purpose of this webcast is to introduce you to Minitab and show you how to enter and import data. When you open Minitab, you will see the session window and a worksheet. The session window will display your statistical results and other output, while the worksheet contains your data. A single worksheet can contain up to 4,000 columns, while the maximum number of rows depends upon your computer's available memory. You can begin by typing your data directly into Minitab. Here you can enter a column name and then simply type your data in the cells below. And if you need to open a new empty worksheet at any time, choose File, New, Minitab Worksheet. Although you can type your data directly into Minitab, you may already have your data in another location, such as Excel. In this case, you can either copy and paste your data into Minitab, or you can import your data. To import Excel files, CSV files, text files, etc., use File, Open Worksheet, and from Files of Type, you can select the appropriate file format. Or, if you need to import your data from a database, you can use File, Query Database, and then select the Machine Data Source tab to get to the list of databases that are available from your computer. Let's go back to File Open Worksheet and open one of the many sample data sets that come with Minitab. We will click this button to get to the sample data sets, and in the Getting Started folder, we will select Shipping Data. This Minitab worksheet, or MTW file, contains data on more than 300 shipments. We can see here that the data are arranged in columns, where each column represents a different variable, and each row represents an individual shipment. You will notice that the column number and format are located at the top of each column. There are three different column formats in Minitab: numeric, text, and date time. Here we can see that the first column is labeled C1-T, where the T indicates that this column is text. Columns C2 and C3 are formatted as date time, while C4 and C6 are formatted as numeric. Minitab automatically formats the columns based on the data found in the first row. Once you have your data in Minitab, you are ready to do your analysis. The menus that you will use most often are the Stat menu and the Graph menu. For example, to create a histogram with a normal curve for the delivery times in column C4, we can simply choose Histogram, Width Fit, and then enter our days column. And if we also want to test if the average delivery time is equal to 5 days, we can choose Stat, Basic Statistics, One Sample T, enter our days column, and then our hypothesized mean of 5 days. In addition to the Stat and Graph menus, you can also analyze your data using the Assistant menu, which helps you find the right tool and interpret your results. To conduct a One Sample T using the Assistant, we can choose Hypothesis Tests, One Sample T, enter our Days column, our target mean of 5 days, and then select Is the mean of days different from 5? Once you've run your analysis and you want to save all of your work, including your graphs and your data, choose File, Save Project. This concludes the webcast on how to get started with Minitab. To learn more about how to analyze your data using Minitab, we offer both instructor-led training and e-learning with Quality Trainer. For more information or to download a free 30-day trial of Minitab 17, please visit minitab.com.